Hey everybody, Jem Schofield here with the C47, and today we're going to be talking about the ZEISS Milvus Super Speed lenses. This video is going to concentrate on an overview of the lenses, so let's get started. In this video in the series, what I want to do is talk about the key features of the lenses, sort of the nuts and bolts, the stuff that has to do with the numbers. And then in other videos in the series, we'll take a look at the visual components of these lenses. And the first thing is, why are they called super speeds? Well, they're called super speeds because all four of these lenses have a maximum aperture of an f1.4. They come in focal lengths of 25 millimeter, 35, 50, and 85, and they're all new lens designs. For the ZEISS Milvus 1.4-25, we have an aperture range of an f1.4 to an f16. We have 15 lens elements in 13 groups. The filter thread on the front of the lens is an 82 millimeter. And the focus throw, the rotation angle of the focusing ring, is 172 degrees. So a nice long throw on these lenses, and of course with hard stops. For the ZEISS Milvus 1.4-35, we have an f1.4 to an f16. We have 14 lens elements in 11 groups. We have a 72 millimeter filter thread and a focus throw of 227 degrees. For the ZEISS Milvus 1.4-50, we have an aperture range of an f1.4 to an f16. There are 10 lens elements in 8 groups. It's a 67 millimeter filter thread and a 225 degree throw for the rotation angle of the focusing ring. And lastly, for the ZEISS Milvus 1.4-85, we have an f1.4 to an f16, 11 lens elements in 9 groups. This is one of my favorite lenses, by the way. A 77 millimeter filter thread, and a 270 degree rotation angle of the focusing ring. So there's a huge Milvus family of lenses which these match with. You can buy them individually or as a set. If you're buying them as a four lens set, it does come in a case with all four lenses. If you're buying them individually in the box, they do come with the lens itself, back and front caps, the lens hood. They all have weather-sealed gaskets. Now, they come in two different lens mounts. We have the ZF, which is for the Nikon F mount, and we also have the ZE, which is what I'm using for most of my camera systems, which is the Canon EF mount. The ZE version, the Canon mount, has contacts on the back of the lens to communicate with the camera body. So if you're changing your aperture, you do that from the camera body that you're using it on. For the ZF or Nikon F mount versions of these lenses, the actual aperture ring is on the barrel of the lens, and that can actually be clicked or declicked so you can pull aperture. So one of the things that you will immediately see from a physical standpoint is that each of these lenses has a different size barrel in terms of the width, in terms of the length. And so that is one of the compromises that you're going to make. It's not really about image quality when you're comparing these to something like, let's say, the CP3s. It's the fact that they're not geared with the gears in the same place on all of the lenses, with the consistency in terms of the barrel sizes and lengths. But ZEISS does have a solution for people like me who are using these lenses in a video production and filmmaking application, and those are the lens gears. They come in various sizes, and they're very easy to use. You loosen them by turning them in opposing directions. You tighten them by turning them in opposing directions the other way. And for me, these lens gears really are what take this set of super speeds and allow me to use it in a lot of different video production and filmmaking environments. We've been using these lenses on all kinds of cameras. So while we're using them, again, on full-frame DSLRs, we're also using them on super 35 millimeter based camera systems that allow us, because of the lens designs, to go all the way up to resolutions of 8K. And that's really the other part of the story. It's not just about the image circle and the coverage that that gives you. It's, can those lenses resolve to those higher resolutions, which is becoming a bigger and bigger part of our productions nowadays. And the other thing about the Zeiss lenses is that they match each other. So when I'm using these super speeds together, I can have the confidence that they're all going to match in terms of their contrast, in terms of the way they render color, in terms of their sharpness. But they're also going to match with the other lenses in the Zeiss Milvus family and other families of lenses that Zeiss makes. So where do I see these lenses being used? Well, I see them being used in small to no crew production, corporate productions. We see a lot of people in-house now, and they may not have the budget to go into the CP3s. So the Milvus Super Speeds are a great option. And I can also see these lenses being used in a variety of different productions for independent filmmakers. Cost-effective solutions with exceptional image quality, gearing them up with the Zeiss lens gears, and having that ability to not only have the confidence of image quality, but to be able to go to these wider apertures for certain looks in production. So I think that's the nuts and bolts stuff having to do with an overview of the Milvus Super Speeds. In the other videos, we're going to be taking a look at what to me is the most important stuff, the images that these lenses can produce. Thanks for watching.